Hello, everybody. My name is Jason Niddle, and this is going to be my very first Let's Play and live stream. So bear with me. There's going to be some bumps and bruises along the way for the first few episodes, but once everything gets rolling, I think it should work out pretty smoothly. I do have a green screen showing up here later on today, and some lights to help make everything look a little better. So right now, you just see my messy back. Part of the room. So, first couple episodes, like I said, it's going to be bumpy. I started a brand new world where I play using Ravishin's Filthy Fabulous items in each section of every world. Hidden lots, vacation spots, and yes, also Batu. James Turner will be proud that I'll be playing Batu. I created a sim named Ben Generated. So I can place the Filthy Fabulous items I created and the abandoned lot that the Let's Play is going to start once the main character or the main sim grows up to become a teen. I call Ben the Architect, which is a nod to the Matrix. I used Twisted Mexi tool to move items off the lot so they into playable areas. So you don't have to load into a lot to be able to interact with these. Once you're in the general area where you can walk around, these items are placed so they can be functional that way. Ben was just, I created him to make a, to use him to play test these things. But since it took so long, you know, I have all the packs, all the kits, all the everything, expansions, all that stuff. So to place it in everywhere I needed to, it took quite a while. I did that before I started doing all this. So Ben, I would play him a little bit, and I figured, okay, his children, one of his children will become the person who's going to be in the generated Let's Play. So he fell in love with the mail lady, and the mail lady would come by, and I started interacting with the mail lady and did some flirting, and then they ended up woohooing in the shower. She got pregnant. She had twins. The first look you saw these people. I have Ben Generated, which is the boy twin, and Ima Generated, which is the female twin, who's also the star of this Let's Play. She's got a little evil side to her, and she's a klepto, and I've used some mods for to make her a beggar and stuff like this. I have a list of everything that I've used in my Let's Play, and if you need to know, just leave me a comment down below, and I'll get back to you and let you know what each thing is. But since I played Ben and they had the children, I wanted to be able to play the child to get her some skills before I just plop her into an abandoned lot and have at it. But that will be just with this first child. After that, the next children, whatever skills they have, will be what is going to be used for the following Let's Plays. It will be a legacy Rags to Riches Let's Play, kind of like James Turner does. He takes a sim, plays it, they have the children, move the children on to the next Let's Play. So I'll be going over everything, high school years, all of them. Everything that is doable, I will do. At least I'll do my best. Like I said, these first few episodes will be a little bumpy. You'll see some, you know, shaking of the camera because I hit the wrong key or something. But within time, I'll get better at it. So I'll be using some mods and some CC. Ravishin mods and CC. I believe I have all of her stuff. I'm a huge fan and supporter of her. She puts her heart and soul in everything she creates. She doesn't really play The Sims, but spends a ton of time creating content for The Sims, which I find remarkable that someone would spend that much time for something they hardly even play. I use a little Dicka CC. I have a fairly large list, most of all of the Deligacy, mostly all of his stuff, and the Deligacy Little Dicka collaborations, which probably won't be used in the Let's Play, this Let's Play, but it's for future Let's Plays, so I have it downloaded. Better Reference Painting by MTS. If I say these names wrong, I am so sorry. Scumbumbo. I also have Carl's Mods, Dine Out, Real Estate, Realistic, Retail, Seasons, and Try to Make Friends. Those are his mods. The Xing Yug 100 Trait Pack, the Absent Emotion Traits, and the Functional Lot and Challenge Traits. I have the Elgato CC Pack, which will be for later. Faster Fishing, I have mine set at times 6, because I think it takes too long to fish. But that can be adjusted. I can just download a slower version. Faster Songwriting, I have it set for DJ booth, keyboard, and lyrics. I left the guitar as is. And from FD, Who Doesn't Like Homework? This way, so kids, when they get home, they'll do their homework on their own. I have Necker Dog's HD Feet, because I like the look of the feet. I have some Floor CC. I'll give a list of that if you ask. A Hair, Beard, and Brow CC. Not a lot, just a few. Keep Instrument in Inventory by Scumbumbo also. Usually when a sim takes their guitar out, or a violin, they'll set it on the ground and leave it. Well, this way when they're done playing, they automatically put it back in their inventory. I have Lewd God and Goddess Trait. I use that for Ben Generator because I want him to be a god. The Matrix reference. I have almost everything that is created by Little Miss Sam. I use MCC Command Center just if there's something that's going wonky and I can cheat it easier that way. If I need to, I'm not going to be using cheats if I don't have to. Nice Decay Lot Trait Extender. Usually when you go to a lot, you can only have 3 traits on it. Well, with this extender, you can add all of them. You can even add all of the challenges if you want. To customize a little more, make it a little more user-friendly. I have Paint Faster. I have mine set at 9 times faster, which is really fast. I will slow that down when I go to the painting part of one of my Let's Plays. I just use that for me when I do my own plays. Also have a roommate. You can set the rent for a roommate anywhere from 0 to, you know, a million simoleons or whatever. That's for something later. I have Sims on Generic Lot. Usually when you go to a generic lot, Sims don't show up there. I'm sorry, I don't know who created it, but you can look up Sims on Generic Lot. You can Google that and it'll pop up. I use some wallpaper CCs, not a lot. Most of it's a Little Dicka, and a couple of various other ones. XML Injector, because a lot of these programs use the same packs or parts of packs. I don't know about that, but I know it needed to be installed or things wouldn't work correctly. Twisted Mexi. I used his Better Build By, always full edit mode, always move objects, always testing cheats. I used his Live Drag, his all scenarios, story progression viewer, and tool. I used the tool to move things off lot when I created the world. I use UI cheats to help for adjusting the money for deductions, because usually, like when you're on a lot and you delete a tree, put the money in your account, well, I'll be able to take it back out. So when Ima moves to this abandoned lot when she runs away, it is cram packed full of trees, shrubs, brush, and all this stuff. And there's some items placed around there that she can use, but she can't access them yet because they're covered by shrubs. So she has to be able to remove these shrubs to get to them, like the barbecue pit. She can't access the barbecue pit because there's like a couple of dead rose bushes and a fern that's growing through it. So what I have is a lot cleanup list that I will be using to remove items. So like if she wants to remove a tree from the lot, it's going to cost her 500 simoleons. If she wants to remove a rock, 75 simoleons each, not just all of them, just each. Shrub removal, this is shrubs and flowers, 50 simoleons each. Animated removal, you know, like the fireflies and stuff like that, it's 10 simoleons each to remove. And I have a pond that I dug using the train tool in there, but it's not full of water. So I have, right now I have set it for 2,000 simoleons that she will need to have to be able to fill this pond. But it will be adjusted depending on the rain level that happens during the Let's Play. Say it rains for 3 or 4 days, I'll go into the train tool and I'll add just a little bit of water. If it rains some more, I'll add just a tiny bit of water. I'll raise it up, and if it gets to a point where it's not full by the time she's ready to fill it up, I'll adjust the 2,000 to whatever I feel reasonable. Traveling now. I cannot travel by using my phone. I must use the Ravishing's Filthy Fabulous bus stop and the AE benches. She has this tuning mod that allows any bench that you can sit on to be activated as a bus stop. And this bus stop is, you can buy a bus pass for 250 simoleons, which gives you a discount on travel. So like, say you want to travel to another venue, it's $5 to travel. But if you have the bus pass, it's only $1. So it, you still have to pay. Just because you have the bus pass doesn't mean you can't pay. And the bus pass is not transferable. The bus pass is in your inventory and it has your name. So if the bus pass isn't in your inventory, you're going to pay full rates. The only exception is if she gets an odd job, she can use the rabbit hole. You know, they walk off the lot and they disappear for a set amount of time and then they come back. I figure it the way as she got this odd job, she doesn't have a vehicle, someone came and picked her up. That's how I see it. So I cannot enter, in the beginning, I cannot enter bars, nightclubs, or any other Sims household except for my family's household, my parents, or her parents' household, at first. I can go to cafes, I can go to parks, I can go to gyms and spas. But if she goes to a gym or spa, I will deduct 15 simoleons each time she goes into one of those lots, like a membership or day pass. Starting out, I must buy Filthy Fabulous items in build buy before upgrading to a better item. So like right now she has the cardboard box which she can sleep on. It's funny, I love the animation on that. But then she also has a bed, which is basically a mattress on a couple of crates, and the mattress is all ripped. I have to upgrade to that before I can upgrade to a bed. Anything I sell must be sold through the Ravishing Dragon Shop kiosk. If I can sell it there, it must be sold there until I have a selling table. I must buy items from the Ravishing Dragon Shop kiosk unless the items that can only be bought from build by Ravishing Filthy Fabulous items only until I am ready to build my very first building, which is going to be a 28 tile storage unit. Can't be any bigger, can't be any smaller. 28 tiles. Using the Ravishing Garage Storage and Door, which is a very cool thing. I think City Living has what looks like a garage door, but it's just display. Well, she makes it where it's an actual door. She has this animation where it rolls up, rolls back down. But not only that, the door itself is a functional storage unit. You can actually store stuff in the door. Like in your inventory or in those boxes that have the little symbols on them, which is kind of cool. So moving on. Okay. I can buy a selling table and the street gallery to sell to the public. I cannot mark up the items until the abandoned lot is cleared out and I have the 28 tile storage unit built, and then I can mark up my prices 50%. So I can buy the table, but I can't mark up whatever the original, I think it's 25%, or I think it's 0.25 or whatever, but I cannot do any markup. So if I sell a seed that's for $2, it's selling for $2. Unless I have my lot cleared and my storage unit built, and then I can mark up the prices 50%. I can dumpster dive for food and items, but they can only be clean used in the ravishing, filthy, fabulous cleaning spray. You know the trait that your Sims have. What is it? Clean, or where you see them walk up to the counter and they spray and they wipe it up. She has taken that spray bottle and made it to become like the eco lifestyle smog vacuum, which I kind of think is cool. But the spray bottle only has like so many uses, and then you have to buy another bottle. So yeah, I can dumpster dive and I can use those items if I want to, but I can't use those items. So say I find a bed, I can't use that bed until I have upgraded my cardboard box to the mattress and crates. Then once I've done that, if I have a bed that I have cleaned in my inventory, I can start using that bed. But before then, I can't. I cannot sell items I own I cannot sell items on my own until I own a retail store, a retail lot. Must be an indoor store I build, so I must have the simoleons to build it. So, which means I can't buy a retail lot, plop in the necessary items needed, and then just have grass and start selling. I must have a functional lot built. Doesn't have to be big. It can be just big enough to put stuff in. So that's the only way I can sell. But I can buy items from Ravishing Guilty's chip vending machine and Ravishing's Soda Lightful vending machine, which I have placed throughout the world. I cannot sell items until I own a retail store. Oh, yeah. So I can't sell the items that I clean and build by. I can only sell it through the retail store. I can remember. First live stream, a little nervous here. It'll get better in time, I promise. I can buy the Ravishing water jug to help reduce my water bills. She has these little water jugs. It's the eco thing, which we'll get more into when we play. I can build a storage unit. Or once I build a storage unit, I can buy the Ravishing vent wind turbine to help generate power. Also another eco item that she had created. I cannot fish until I buy a fishing pole. This is one thing that I thought was pretty cool. Usually you can walk up to one of the fishing signs and just start fishing. Well, gotta have a fishing pole. They're not born with a fishing pole in their pocket. So she's gonna have to buy one. Buying one means it's gonna cost her 150 simoleons. Is that what I put here? Yes, 150 simoleons. So when it's time for her to start fishing, I will deduct that $150 from her. And then I'll allow her to fish. If I want to get an odd job, I must use the Ravishing Filthy Fabulous used laptop. She has this used laptop that looks all junky. It's for 500 simoleons, and I think it breaks down quite often. I haven't play tested it yet, but the description says it may not be as reliable as you think or something like that. So, but she cannot use it on her lot. She has to go to another location to be able to use the laptop to get an odd job. So, which means she has to use the bus to go to another venue to get the odd job. And then I guess if she wanted to, she can wait around until the rabbit hole takes her to the odd job, or she can go back home or whatever. But yes, she cannot use the laptop in her abandoned lot, at least until after she has the storage unit set up and she's got power back, because it will be simple living and off the grid until then, her lot. So the retail store, when she builds the retail store, 50% markup until she earns 5,000 simoleons. After she earns 5,000 simoleons, she can mark up anything to 75% until she makes an additional 10K. After she makes that additional 10K, there's no limit and restriction. She can set it to 300% if she wants. The retail store that she builds can be a live-in retail store. But then again, she can't build this retail store until she has the 28-tile storage unit built on her lot, which means her lot needs to be emptied. Once you see this lot, you'll know it's going to take her a while. She can't do it all in one day. So my end goal is to have a house worth at least 200,000 simoleons and a child ready to take over the Rags to Riches Legacy gameplay. So, and I don't know if I'll be cheating the abandoned lot rent, so we will see. And I believe the lot is somewhere around 8,000 simoleons to get the lot. So I will give her the money for the lot, take away her money back down to zero, and the only money she has will be in her piggy bank, and the piggy bank that she steals from her brother and her mother, which isn't a lot. There's, I think, no more than like 200 simoleons combined in it, maybe a few dollars more. So with that said, let's get started. I like I said, I played this family, the generated family, to get the teen, or to get these children up to a point where they're ready to become a teen. We will start this. I believe I have it set to where she's in her bedroom. She's mad as hell, and she was getting ready to take it out on her teddy bear. But I don't know if it'll load that way or not. But Mama's going to make a cake. She's going to blow out the candles. They'll put new candles on it for the twin brother, just generated. And later that night, I'm a generated. We'll move out. Well, not move out. She will sneak out of the house and run away. I will get her to the abandoned lot, which she has the money because, you know, it's still, she's still within the household. She will, I'll get her to that abandoned lot, and then I will go into the sim tab where you can separate households and stuff like that. Give her enough money to get on that lot, then load in to I'm a generated, buy that lot, and then take the rest of the money away. And then let the other family just play themselves out. I may move out the brother. Oh no, the brother's still be in high school. And she will technically be in high school. I don't know if she's going to go to high school, or she'll just skip high school altogether, or drop out. We'll see. So I don't know. I may have her go to high school. I just may. She may not do very good because she's meanie. But we'll see how this goes. Like I said, these first few episodes are going to be very clunky, and I apologize. You know, I've watched Deligracy, James Turner, and Dr. Gluana. I've watched all of their videos, taking notes on how they're doing certain things. I'm not going to try to imitate them. I do respect the way they play their games, and I will try to follow their... I try to follow the way they play. They're good. They're great streamers, and they play The Sims 4 to death. Oh my gosh. I've been playing The Sims 4 for, God, my thing says I've got over 3,000 hours playing. So I'm not a noob at Sims. I played the very first one. I think it was on my phone when I was younger. I'm 53, so this is a big start. I'm a retired, no, not a retired. I'm a disabled vet, Desert Storm vet. I'm a retired executive chef, and I I'm also a filmmaker. I have several films that are out in distribution right now, independent filmmaker. So I still have that going on, and I spend a lot of time playing The Sims. I also play other games, which I will get into doing Let's Plays on those, but not at first. I want to concentrate on this legacy. I will be doing some live streams later once I figure out this whole setup, because I have a bunch of stuff that came from Amazon. Oh my gosh, everything, the Delgado Stream Deck I ordered, which will be here later today, the microphone system, my camera, everything. So I'm using the, well, you don't need all that. So let's get started. All right, so we're gonna load in here. She doesn't, oh, and there's a surprise. If you watch the first look video, it shows the family and everybody here before we get started. Yeah, she's gonna beat up this teddy bear or yell at it or something. Before we get started, I did a first look before I had my webcam and everything, and I edited it and put it together with some titles and stuff and some crappy music. Yeah, I'll get better with the music. But so we had the mother, the father, Ben, Justin, just generated, and I'm a generated. Well, during my playing, while I was waiting for the everything else to show up, the mother got pregnant. I didn't know about it until you saw the little thing pop up on the side saying, eating for two. I'm like, oh, great. I have this thing already built out, or the first look already did. So there's an addition to the family. I will show you her in just a second. But so we have, I'm a generated right here. And over here, we have just generated. He's the goody two-shoe of the family. Let's see where the rest of the family is. Let me just drop this. Make it easier. Oh, there she is. This is, she used to be the male lady, Emma generated. And Ben generated is right here. All of his clothing is white, based off the Matrix from the architect. So, yeah. And the new addition to the family is Wind generated. She was a surprise to me as much as she is to you. So, yeah. So there's a new addition to the family. I guess she's mad. What is she mad at? Oh, yeah. I don't know. She's yelling at somebody. So, we're going to start this gameplay off watching her. Let me first get a cake started with Daddy Boy here. Let's build a cake first. Cake. not bake. It's under cook, right? Figure cakes would be under baking, but they're not. Let's get her chocolate cake. Why not? All right, Daddy's gonna be Ben's gonna be doing that while we proceed to start the show. All right, she's over here yelling at this stuffed teddy bear. I don't know why, and she's loving it. All right, so we follow her. Let's see where she's going. Oh yeah, so she doesn't have a very good relationship with everybody. Bun Bun over here, she has a negative relationship. Everybody else, somewhat. Her parents, she doesn't have much of a relationship with, you know, halfway. But her twin brother and her baby sister, she's friends with. So, she's not like cold-hearted to everybody. Come on, Daddy, finish up your cake. Let's get this thing started. So yeah, this house right here, I'll show you that before I move her out. This came off of, I don't know who it's created by. I'll let you know when I go into Build By and I'll show it to you. This was actually a two-room place. It was a bedroom and a small room right here. This room here, all these rooms back here were added. This bathroom was added because the bathroom was actually in the bedroom, and they just had a couple of walls extensions to separate it and a curtain. So once he ended up marrying Emma, I made it a little bigger, and then when they had the twins, I added this room, and then it became a nursery, and then it became this, and then just recently I had to add this. So this is the house from the outside, and yes, of course there is Batuu stuff here, because doing my let's play, or doing my, let's say, doing my world setup. He had to go to Batu to place the bus stops. And then while I was there, I spent a couple hours doing some stuff. He's for the resistance, of course. So, and he does have a droid, but his droid is actually in his inventory, which I will pull out right now. The reason why he's in the inventory, because he would walk around the house shocking everybody and putting them in a freaking coma. Sorry. Putting them in a coma, or not a coma, but asleep, and draining their energy. So I just put him away. I don't know why he's doing that. But yeah, he's got his lightsaber here, and a couple of Batu things around the house. But yeah, he doesn't really have a job. It just, if you've ever played Batu, you get assigned, you get things to do while you're there, not just play, walk around and do nothing. So here's the cake. Let's get it and drag it over here. Center it. Remember, clunky at first. Center. Now it's centered. All right, Daddy. Add candles. All right, let's do just generated first. Get Jess to blow out these candles. Come on, Jess. Time to age up, boy. You can't do it. Why not? Is it not centered? Let's try that now. Blow out candles. Can you blow out candles? Stop talking to your parents. What's the matter? See? Blow out candles. Come on, try it. Try it again. Alright. Alright, let's go into build by real quick. Let's pull out a table just so we can do this. Let's just pop this out here. You're going right there for right now. Put you right in the center. Let's move you into the over here right now. Alright. Now can you blow it out? There you go. I don't know why that wouldn't blow out on there, but alright, let's get Daddy to put more candles on there before someone eats it. Are they going to celebrate? Are they celebrating his... I don't know why. Let me run all the way outside to age up. Woohoo! Yeah. Alright, so he's brilliant, right? And let's stay... Like I said, I have all the... bunch of traits here. So let's give him something artistic. Let's make him analytical. Analytical sims are great, build mental skills. They get focused and using mental skills, writing skills, and mischief skills. Huh. Analytical, huh? Alright, so let's give him... Let's make him, I don't know, athletic. Standard go-to. Let's see what he looks like. Looks good. Yep, gonna need a makeover. Alright. So, come on, Dad. Put in those... Let's get you over here. And let's get... I'm a generator to add up. And here is our lady of the hour. Let's see what she looks like. And, of course, she's going to have to walk all the way. Oh, no, see? She klepto. Let's do... Let me figure this out. She is... I got a bunch of them. Let me scroll through here real quick and figure out what I want her to be. I don't want her to be anything good. Oh, neat. Neat was that thing, not clean. Neat, when those Sims come in and they spray the counters and stuff, they've got this neat trait. That's what Ravishing took, that bottle, and used as a, what do you call it? The smog vacuum. She did her version of it. she's going to be running away. Not freaking. Enjoy readers and thrown away. Yeah, let's make her a freaking for right now. And her trait, where is the... All right, so here's a trait that I have. It's called Queen of Thieves, and it's also King of Thieves if it's a male. This ne'er-do-well sim wants to earn money by emptying her fellow sims' pockets. All right. Villainous Valentine. All right, so we're going to do that. Ooh, look at her. Hello. Oh, look at her. Her little face. I got to screenshot that. Okay. She looks mean. All right. So, everybody's aged up. Here, let's just yell at your dad for making this cake. We got to get your mischief up. Act tough. Act tough. Let's see what else. Insult. And demand independence. Yeah. She's already fighting. Mom is sitting here like, oh yeah, hon. You got it made. You have nothing to worry about. All right. Look at that. She's doing homework. Maybe I will put her in school. Just ignoring dad. All right. So, let's go into cast. Let's change up their look a little bit. Get them ready. Modifying cast. All right, let's start with just generated. All righty. Let's get him something like that. Remove all jewelry. Didn't need all that fancy stuff. Huh. Let's get him. I like that. I like that shirt. All right. Get him some cargo pants. That's what I like to wear, cargo pants. He's got a long body. All right. So that one's set. That looks good. All right. Maybe a little smaller. That looks fine. Sleepwear. Yeah, crazy. Let's get him some jammies on. That'll work. Oh, no, this ain't sleepwear. This is party wear. My bad. All right. Let's see. Party down. Let's get to see. That looks good. Your shoes. Like the shoes. Don't like the color. Just make them black. All right. Sleepwear. I was wondering why is he wearing shoes. Oh, slippers. I think... Whatever. This looks okay. Let's just put him in some shorts. There you go. Activewear. What kind of jacket is that? That's not it. Put you in some shorts and tank top. Let's get you this. That'll work. All right. Business wear. Hey, that looks good. Pants. Not so much. Oh, look at that. Clean cut, dude. Clean cut, dude. All right. Oh. This is a disaster. Let's get him. I don't know. Regular jeans. Oh, yeah. Cowboy boots. You gotta go. I wear cowboy boots, but not on the outside of my pants. Shirt. Here we go. Shirt. No. How about this? There we go. And then boots. Let's do these. Hey, look at that. Looking good. Looking good, kid. All right, let's give you hair. I got some custom content here that I use. Yeah, I like that. That's too red, huh? Over here. Still red. Nobody in the family has red hair. I guess that'll work. All right, does that go for all of them? Yeah, there you go. Clean cut kit. Alrighty. Oh, yeah, see, I have the extensions. I can give him a couple more traits here now. It's, he's creative. And let's go over here. Friendly. Alright. I'm a generated. Alright, little Miss Ima. Is that Ima? No, that's not Ima. This is Ima. That's Emma. Alright. Let's see. Hair. This is by Andenya. Like I said, I have a list of this CC hair in my folder. If anyone wants to know exactly who it is, I'll let you know. So let me go here and put it on this one. That should go to all of them, right? Yeah. All right. So I like that. Running away from home. Let's get her some jeans. I think I've got some custom content designed for my Rags to Riches. Yeah. Nope. Get rid of the boots. Let's see. Yeah, that'll work. Business. Okay, I've got some stuff here. Take away the formal. Yeah, there we go. Alright. This is more apocalyptic stuff, but it works for the Rags to Riches. Yeah, she can wear that. That looks good. And then I want to change out these boots. I have a special set of boots that I want to use. These right here. There you go. All right. Top. That'll work. Bottom. Let's see. Custom content. Get a pair of shorts. There you go. And her shoes. Get her a pair of tennis shoes. That'll work. A pair of socks. looking good, kid. All right. Right shirt, wrong. Why'd she have glasses? She didn't have glasses any other time. Get rid of this stuff. All right. This shirt right here. Same style, but it's dirty. I think they're different colors. Yeah. She's going to be sleeping outside anyway, so this is her filthy shirt. no shoes. I'm going to give her some socks. I like this outfit, but it's too clean cut. Maybe I'll do it as a second outfit. Change the colors on it, though. So let's go back to the first one. I don't think I have any custom content for this. Oh, I do. All right. Yeah, and a jacket. All right, so let's go with this. I'll stick with those jeans. Give her her boots. Oh, they stick through. All right, let me find another pair of boots. Black. Black, black. That'll work. All right. Yeah, we'll stick with that for her party. We have this other one here, which I like, but I want to use a different jacket. I'm going to use this jacket. Yeah. I like that. Go back to the boots. Those other boots, where are they at? Right here. What do we do? Back around. That'll work. All right, swimwear. Going with this shirt again. Reusing items. She's already got a pair of them. That's her swimwear and her hot weather wear. Let's do this. I think she's got another color. Something like that. Let's do that. All right. And let's give her some rolled up jeans. All right. And her boots. Boots. No, I want to use the other one. Alrighty. And then this, of course, we've got that jacket that we'll be using right here. And pants. Gosh. Let's see. I guess we can do the white ones, right? That other outfit. Green. Okay. There it is. All right. And then go back to those other boots. Something like that. All right. So now let's give her a couple more things. So this is where we can add more things to her list. Heartbreaker. No. Oh, wrong category. Ruthless. helicopter. Sorry about that, guys. Wow. There is one here that I'm looking for, and I'm just going right by it. Cruel. There we go. All right. So there's I'm a generator. This is the whole family. All right. Good to go. I'm going to save this to my gallery. Real quick. And then I'll put I'm a generated up separately once she's separated from the family. So let's get back into gameplay. So yeah, what I plan to do is use for Ima to get money is probably some gardening, dumpster diving, and some what was it? Begging and pickpocketing, of course. But odd jobs. So she's gonna get odd jobs. Which means her skills need to be up if I think to get bonuses or get paid or whatever. So there's certain things. Some of them are pretty good pay, a couple $100 here and there, but they're usually for the mischief trait, which she's got mischief. So I think that'll work. So let's let her do her homework. It's 10:30 p.m. I want to wait until... Oh, I've got a trait on here. Here, let me take it off. I want people to go to bed at night. I have it on because I didn't want to mess with everyone getting tired and everything. I think it's the advanced trait. Yeah. I'm going to take that off. People can go to sleep. Private dwelling, I'll take that one off. Let's see what we got here. Convenient? Nah. Take that off. Yeah, see, this lot trade challenge I have, this will rotate. Every so often, I'll get a notification saying that lots challenges have been added. Which is kind of frustrating when I'm trying to do a rags to riches where I want them living off the lot and or off the grid and simple living because it'll rotate them out. So I got to go back in and fix them. So let's just add a couple things here. Comfortable. Whatever. We're not playing them anyways after we leave. Okay, go back to this. So I noticed that Daddy is good at his cooking. Let's see. That's not Daddy's cooking. So let's do a little cheating here. Let's have Daddy cook. Oh, hang on. Before we do that, let me get rid of this counter. I think its skills are maxed out, aren't they? Cooking. No, they're not. Oh, I thought they were. Huh. That's interesting. Oh, that was another one I was playing. Yeah. So the food was spoiled anyway. So that's not going to work. I was going to have Daddy cook a couple of meals in her pack lunches so she can take it with her. But, yeah, that'll work. So, let her finish her homework. She's almost done. Let's see what's just generated doing. He's sitting in here. Yeah, talking to Mama. But why do I have to share a room? Why do I have to share? Honey, you have to share a room with your sister. You know this, but the place isn't big enough. I know, Mom. I know, but no buts, honey. You know, you just got to do it. All right, Mom, if you say so, I'll do it. Good boy. All right, let's see. She's over there scribbling away on her homework. Daddy's over here. What's she doing? What are you doing? Just standing there looking at the couch. So I thought it'd be cool to name these kids after generated products, like when generated. But I'm going to run out of names fairly quick. Oh, and the Rags to Riches, the name will stay, whether it's male or female. So, like, if a Sim gets married and takes on the next family, she will keep the name, the generated name. So, oh, look, he's over here talking to his thing. They're arguing about the First Order. Woohoo! Oh, no, was that the Resistance? I don't know. All right, so, want to get her to finish her homework. Oh, he's got mischief skills, too. He has no freaking skills. You can tell I wasn't playing him. All right. Little one, let's get you started on your path to leaving. Let's get you in here. Walk over here. Make sure nobody's coming. And I want you to steal the money out of the piggy bank. Let's see how much money's in it first. $103. Steal money. Alright, she stole the money. There isn't any money left, right? Nope. Alright, come over here. Nobody in the bedroom? Come in the bedroom real quick. Go here. Hurry, hurry. Come on. Steal your brother's piggy bank. How much money has he got in there? 21 simoleons. Do it. Steal it. Get yourself ready. So 103 plus 21. Let's do that. Add money. 103 plus 21, so that's what? 124? Right? 124. Just adding that money into here. Boom. So she has $189. 189 simoleons that she's going to have once she runs away from home. Which isn't a lot. This is after we move her in to the new lot and then take away all of her money. This will be in her inventory, so we can't take it away from her. So what she's going to do is she's going to start, I'm going to start putting stuff in her inventory. Oh, I thought this goes in the inventory. Hang on a second. May have to do a quick adjustment. Piggy bank's going in the inventory. Hang on, let me see. Tip jar. Did go in inventory. Dang it. Let's see. Where is he at? Just generated. This should go in his inventory. It doesn't. What goes in the inventory? Is it the other money bag? All right. Little adjustment, guys. Because I want to have the money that I can't take away from her. So I'm going to go into Build By real quick. Copy this. Boom. It should take me to right where I need to go. This is what I like about Better Build By. You can extend your viewing area so it's easier to find things. So let's just go here, show all. I don't have a lot of stuff in my CC, so it won't be too hard. Yeah, this is a bunk bed that Ravishing, or not a bunk bed, a cot that Ravishing was working on for me. It's still not complete. It has some issues with it. Hopefully, she'll get some time to be able to fix it up for me. Which can go in your inventory. It's a cot. And we're going to try to get the trunk taken off the front of it and everything and just make it a cot. So, let me get back to what I was doing. Where are you at? Piggy banks. Oh, this is that spray I was talking about. You can use it to spray bottle that you put in your inventory and use it to clean smoggy items. Piggy banks. So here's that first one. Oh, and these backpacks. I love these backpacks by Around the Sims 4. They're basically a functional wardrobe that you can put in your inventory. So you always have a way to do it. Piggy banks. Did I pass it? Yeah, right here. Bag o' cash. Just like the one you get from doing the criminal thing, but this is a functional item. Let me get out of here and see if I can put that in my inventory. Can I not? I thought they went in your inventory. Do you have to be a certain age to have it? Let's see. Let's check you out. Huh. Something's not right. All right. So what we will do is place this tip jar at the lot. I thought it went in your inventory. I don't know what's going on. Let's see. There might be a way to cheat around it. Let me go into here. Go into storage. Yes. Yeah, see? Oh, no, is that Robertson's? Yeah. That should go in your storage. Huh. See, issues. Working them out, people. All right, let's see. What was I doing? Oh, yeah. Get rid of height matches. This box right here. I love this box. Too big, but I love it. You can store stuff, and I always take mine and make it smaller, either this size or this size, and then I put it in my inventory. Now let's see, can that go in? Let's see, open this up. No, it won't go in. Huh, I don't know, I don't get it. All right, it was working before, maybe it was an old version or something. I don't know, but you can steal from these. So let's just get rid of these. And we'll, like I said, we will place a, oh, she can take that with her. She will, we will place a money jar on the abandoned lot for when she gets there, and then that's the monies that she has. Yeah, I don't know why. It's supposed to be able to go in there. Whatever. So, back to where we were. She's going to start putting stuff in her inventory. Laptop is portable, right? Putting him, oh yeah, she can't take it with her. Darn it. Remember, she can only use filthy fabulous items. So I guess she ain't taking that. She's gonna put this in her inventory. She's gonna put this in. Oh, not you, Daddy. Stop it. All right, place an inventory, put an inventory, and there's this little thing. While I've been doing my playing on my own, she has been collecting items. Pomegranate potato. Oh, and she, her skills. What I did is I took the bookshelf and took all the books out of it because they were non-fully reading books. And I thought, well, if they're going to read something, I'm going to put something in there I want them to read. So I put the vampire. I put some skill books in there, and then I thought, okay, I'll order the vampire books and put them in there. So I had her start learning about the vampire lore, and then she got the book, and she read the entire book, and then she bought the next one and the next one. So I have the book. She's going to keep them, even though she doesn't need them. She got all four of them. And her little knitting basket, something to play with. As she stole the money tree, I put it on a lot, and she went and stole it. Well, actually, just put it in there. I don't know if I ever use it, but I've got it. And seed packets. Her little tablet, which she she can't use. I'll leave it here. I forgot. She's not able to use it. Her beanie that she made. She got a couple of beanies in a plasma pack. And then she's got this stuff here, which I will give them to just generated because she won't be using them. She's got her headphones, which she can use. She got these off of the board over here. And her books, let's just sell these books. Oh, yeah, gotta turn this on. Sell that. She won't be near. Let's just sell these. Okay, so she is in the process of doing that, so she can actually put this in her inventory too, right? Yeah. So let her place these items in her inventory. Ooh, it's snowing outside. Ooh, not a good time to run away. All right, and then she's gonna steal these because she found these. Well, she's not really stealing them, I guess, huh? Oh yeah, she can't. She'll come back and steal this money. Sorry, my dog. All right. So it is nighttime. Let's get everyone to go to sleep. Let me turn this on. Show all the lights. I have Ravishing's hidden lights. I don't think I have them on auto. Let me put them on auto. Auto lights. All lights. Yeah, they're not on auto. All right, now. I love these lights. They're very bright. She has three different kinds. One that goes on her counters, one that's directional, and then these floor lights, or ceiling lights. But you can hide them. See? And now they're gone. Kind of cool. I like it. All right, so let's get everybody in bed. What's she doing? Aw. She's cute. She was an unexpected surprise. So, looks like people are hungry now, huh? Let's get everyone just to go to sleep. And then I'm going to have to come back and unlock the door because if I don't, then the kid just generated won't be able to get out. Because I got to lock the door so she can sneak out so I can make this look good. Sleep. All right. Sleep. And Mama's going to sleep. Let's get little one to sleep. And let's get you to sleep. At least pretend like you're sleeping. All right. You know what? Let's check her needs first before we do this. She's hungry and she's sleeping. So let's get her to eat first. You would take the last one. Open the refrigerator. What have we got in here? Where'd that cake go I made? Oh, never mind. Eat that. Macaroni and cheese. All right, so we got her stuff in her inventory. She has some medicine that she bought because she's been preparing on leaving. She's going to steal this camera here, so put that in her inventory. She's going to take this, but she's going to come back and steal it at a later time. Oh, look at her. She's already getting ready. She's going to take everyone to sleep. She's like, yeah, best time to get it. Yeah, everyone's sleeping. Mine now. Suckers. Oh, and she's going to take this guitar. And everyone's going to wake up in the morning and all the stuff's going to be gone. Shame, shame, shame. Oh, look at that. She swept that from way over there. All right, finish eating, hon. All right. Because it's time for you to act like you're sleeping. All right, so let's do this. I haven't even used this yet, I think it's kind of a cool thing. But I guess you got to lock the door, because if you don't, they'll find another way out. Let's see. Locked door for her. There you go. Now she can't get back in this room. All right. Here we go, folks. She's going to get up. Oh, didn't mean to do that. She glitches. All right. So go here. Oh, not you. All right, get out of bed. Go here. Sneak out. I think she can sneak out, right? Yeah. That's so cool. First time I've ever used that window. All right. She's a little runaway. Hi, folks. It begins. Dun, dun, dun. All right, so let's get her to travel. Let's use the bus system. Can I buy her? No, I'm not going to buy her bus pass, but she's going to use the bus system. I got the bus way over here. See, so I set this up to where she has to actually go to it. So yeah, I moved it off the lot, so it makes this functional. It just gives it more realism, you know, she's got to go catch the bus. So talking with Ravishing, I was discussing with her, I think it should be cool if this had like a time system, like, kind of like the kiosk does. It's open from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. or something like that, or whatever it is. The bus system should be like that too. It should end at like 2 o'clock in the morning and start back up at 8 or something like that. But on top of that, have a schedule, run every 15 minutes. So like, say it's 8:28, the next bus doesn't show up until 8:30. Or if she gets here at 8:31, she's got to wait until 8:45 for the next bus. And then also have another one that's functional for a taxi, which are like immediate, but they cost more. And you can't get a pass for that. So, let's do this. She's going to travel. Standard travel. See, you can go to Hidden Lots. Has all the Hidden Lots available. You can purchase a bus pass, but we're not going to do that right now. We're not going to cheat that part. Oh, and then you can also invite to hang out at current lot. So, you can invite people here. You don't have to go, this person, this person, this person. You can click it. I don't want to do that because it'll open up that screen. And you can select 8 people to come to this bus stop and hang out with you. So like if there's one by your house or by a nightclub or whatever. So standard travel, general venue, $5. You see that? It was $5. With the bus pass, it becomes $1. So even though you're riding, you've got the bus pass, you still got to pay. All right. Oh, are you admiring the snow? Let's travel. I hope it's not snowing at the new location. Man. And where did I move her to? I moved her to Benilton Bay. Oh, it's going to be snowing there. Yep. This lot right here. Abandoned lot. See, I already have stuff here. You got the touch and better skill building. Bracing breeze because there's no walls. It's a dog hangout. It's a geothermal, which reduces the water bill. Great soil, let it grow. Private dwelling, lighten the load, and natural light. Those are the lot traits that I have for it. And once we get in there, I'll add the off the grid and simple living to it. So let's move her here. No, let's move her to... how do I do this? Because she's not necessarily moving here. She's going here. I guess it doesn't matter where I put her, huh? So let's just go here for right now. Because I got to move her out and then move her into that lot. Well, I'll show you that lot here in just a second. Usually when I move them out, they're already in the household, living in the house, and I just separate them and let them leave. All right. So it doesn't matter where you are. So let's save and go to manage worlds. And it's snowing here. Oh, this is going to be a hell of a winter. But she does have a winter seed packet. So, she does have some options to grow stuff. All right. So, let's go to the manage households. I have a couple of things here. I have Kane, this guy here. I built him to do a shell challenge. So, a tiny home shell challenge. And I used him to play test. She's just someone that I just made. And... she's like pure. She's kind of like I'm a generated, but she lives on her own. She's wealthy and all this stuff. And these are debug families. So these people pulled off a debug. They come with the outfit, which unlocks the outfit for the household. So like, if you want to have the male lady outfit, you can never get it unless you're a male lady. Well, if you want it, or the maid outfit or whatever. If you want to do that, what you can do is go into CAS and go into the gallery and type in debug and make sure you're on household. And then all these people show up. Not all together. I just put them all in one household just because I thought it'd be funny. And once you pull that person into your family, it unlocks everything job related. And then what you do is you can either keep that person in your family or just make them a townie. Don't delete the sim. Just make them a townie, and it keeps everything unlocked for you. Just a cheat. I learned that like 2 or 3 days ago. So, yeah, that's a new family over there. So, let's go configure custom neighborhood. No. Let's swap around. Oops, sorry. Let's move I'm a generated to create a new household. I'm a generated. Right? Make sure I'm doing this right. Yes. I gotta make sure I give her money. So let me transfer over. Let's just do 20,000. I'll take all that money away once she's on her loan. All right, so she's moved out. That's how I'm a generated, right? That's not the mother. All right, she looks so much like her mother. With a little bit of her dad's features. I like that. All right. She is on her own, so let's move her in. All right. Let's go back to Burlington Bay, to the abandoned lot. Furnished. Yes. Alright, guys. We will start this let's play. I can't believe it's during the dead of winter. It's going to be rough. I gotta keep her from freezing. Alright, here she is. Where's her lot? Oh, it's over here. All right. Let's get over here. There's only one way into this lot. I built it that way. Oh, she's excited. All right. So, here's the lot. I'll give you a little tour of it. You can come in here. It looks a lot. It doesn't look as bad during the winter because all this stuff is dead. But before, when it wasn't dead... you can barely even see inside this lot. but I have it all the way around, perimetered with rocks and bushes, so you can't walk through. So, a little recap. So, inside here is an ice cooler. There's a shrub and like four or five dead rose bushes here that have to get, you can kind of see it right there, that have to get removed before she can use it. And what did I say? That shrubs were 75 simoleons to remove shrubbery. So that's going to cost a few hundred simoleons to get. I did make this to where she can lay on this cardboard box. She can just squeeze right in here. And I think she can sit on this. But yeah, if she wants to access anything else or have more space, she's got to get rid of this stuff, which is going to cost money. She can't cook a little bit here. She can't use the barbecue because it's surrounded. Got the dead rose bushes from Vampire Living growing through it. She does have access to this tire, which is by Ravishing, to plant. And there are some more over here, but she cannot access them because there's rose bushes going through them. So 75 simoleons to be able to use them. And there is hidden in here a trash can, a trash bin, which before she can use it, she got to clear it out. So it's kind of nice being winter because I can show you some of these things. So, like, down here looks like a ravine, but it's a pond with no water in it. And you see this right here? This is a toolbox, which is one of those storage units. Inventory. It's got inventory slots in it. So, she can access that when she gets to it. But I don't think... I think she might be able to maneuver her way through there. But, like I was saying... No water, so to get water, she has to pay. But since it's snowing, I think I might, once the time comes, raise the level a little bit. But she has to remove this rock, this, and this, and I think the tree. The one tree, is there one tree down there? No, there's two trees down there. And these two trees before I do that. So yeah, and I do have shelter. See the shelter? This is by Ravishing. The shelter top. She also has one that's invisible, and I do have it placed, one placed right here, one placed right here, and one placed right here, just to give her a little more shelter. Because, you know, like thunderstorms and rain and snow, when they need to hide for shelter, they find a place to hide. So I have that here. But it's not a lot, you know, even though it's hidden, it's still snowing. There's still snow on the ground, just like there's snow on the ground here. But it is a functional shelter. So yeah, that's it. So let's get her started in her new adventure. Let's see what bills are going to be. Show bills. Oh yeah, before I do that, let's go in here and make this off the grid and simple living. Challenges. Oh, and I also want to make it filthy, right? From clubs. No, Grody. No. What's the one that gives you this one right here? Add that. That way the trash bin will fill up. Simple living and off the grid, right? Is that what I said? Yes. All right. So, reduce and recycle, which means those trash bins will fill up on their own. I can also, once we're off of here, I will make this a landfill area. And yes, I know you can't make residential landfill, but you can with the cheap. So I will do that, and people will deliver stuff here, like TVs and refrigerators and stoves. So every once in a while. And this is dog friendly, so we will have dogs coming in, and I'll eventually get a dog, probably, if I find one I like. So yeah, we have that done a lot. All right. wish there was a way to hide the phone feature for Rags to Riches. There you go. Somebody make that. Something you can toggle on and off. Let's see. Bills. Show bills. $46. I think we can handle that. I think we can have, see, tax breaks, because I got it. Oh, yeah, I'll show you where I got it. Got a little pump sitting in over here, I believe, which is generating water, yeah. Or something's generating, but we'll figure it out. Oh, yeah, because I have natural well, so we're generating something. So we got some tax breaks going on, which covers most of it. So, yeah, I think for now I'll leave it where she has to pay her taxes. That's going to be fun. All right, guys. So, first off, let me get this money jar over here. Like I said, we were going to do. Let's put it right here. Let's go into build mode real quick. Money jar. Where was it? I keep forgetting. Show all. Access. All right, let me scroll down. There's the piggy bank. I know you guys are like, it's right there, it's right there. Oh, and here's the dog bowl. It's kind of cool. It looks like a pizza box. There it is, money jar. All right, let's put that bad boy right there. And what was it? She is going to add $198, $189, or simoleon, sorry. All right. Let's see if she can get to it first. So. And then I'll take her remaining money. Oh, oh God. Not a good start. Not a good start. Fell right in the mud. Poor Emma. Money's added. Let's see. Yeah, I gotta remember. I gotta see. Since I have that invisible shelter here, I can't click underneath. It thinks it's that, so I gotta get closer. All right, $189. All right, here we go, folks. She is broke. Bam. I'm a broke generator. Look at her freezing. All right, so she has some stuff on her. Let's get started. All right, let's get her backpack out. Let's get her little box out. This box. Oh, God. I gotta resize that thing. I'll resize it in a second. Figurines and the stuff she can keep on her. All right, let me go into build real quick and reduce the size of this thing. Let's make it a small box. That's the same size as that one. And shove that thing right up in there. Bam. Get that out of the way. Oh, yeah, but she can't sit down now. So it had to be anywhere near. All right. So, yeah, we're here. Simple living. She can light it, even though it looks like it's lit. And get herself a little warmth going on here. Ooh. Oh, put yourself out. Put yourself out. All right. Oh, adds a little light there, too. Look at that. All right, let's see. Extinguish, no, play, roast. Oh, she doesn't have much. So if she's going to eat after this thing, like if she's going to roast marshmallows, I will take a dollar from her for each marshmallow she has. It's her treat. It's our treat, right? Our treat. So she's going to have her first marshmallow. She's going to get some sleep, and then in the morning we will start our adventure. All right. Good to go. Oh, she farted. Woo. Oh, she acquired the cooking skill. All right. Good to go, girl. I forgot you hadn't cooked it anything, huh? Oh, you got to pee? Oh, yeah. And I got a pee bush over there. Or is she sleeping in it? She ain't sleeping in the pee bush. Nope. No napping. You're going to nap right here. You're going to actually sleep. She's all... She's like, boom. That is so funny. She is out like a light. Yeah, using that invisible shelter helps, you know, so she doesn't, like, freeze to death out here and everything. That's kind of cool. I like that. Because normally, you know, they, if you were living in a place like this, you'd have bulkier clothes, blankets, and a sleeping bag and all that crazy shit. Oh, stuff, sorry. Okay. I'm working on that, too. All that crazy stuff. Just to get a... But it's the Sams can't have all that. So these invisible shelters are something, a way to work around that. So I think in the morning, when she wakes up, it is storming something bad out here. Gosh. Oh, and I do have Carl's Seasons mods, which means she can grow any time of year. So, I think that's enough sleep for you, girl. Let's empty your bladder. What are you doing? Run inside. Okay, run inside. Where's the inside? Oh, you were inside. Whoa. God, blizzard. I can't even see my mouse. Oh, yeah. Use it. Fertilize it. Oh, do I have a turn backwards? I didn't play test this. I figured it would fit. No, I did play test it. I guess you can access it from out there, too. And I don't know how she got out there. I had that blocked. Oh, well. Oh, yeah. So, let's see if she can go here. Oh, I guess she can walk through the rocks, huh? Oh, well. All right. I guess it wasn't as fancy as I thought it would be. Okay, guys. So, let's get her planting something so she can eat. Let's see what we got here. Let's open up the box. Oh, yeah. Keep forgetting. I gotta get closer. What do we have here that she can eat? Potatoes. Spring, summer, fall, winter. Yeah, let's put that in her inventory. Even though I said I got Carl's mods, let's stick as close as we can to the season. Let's place this in here. Have her plant it and water it. It's too cold to plant. Hang on. Let me fix that. More choices. Season settings. Always in season. On. Always healthy. On. Alright. That'll work. Now it should work. Should is the key word. If not, I'll have another. Yep. There we go. I think it is. Come on, guys. Hang on. Malfunction. Malfunction. Get that seed out of there. Cold. How about if I put it right here? Under the shelter. Where's the shelter at? I have shelter there, there, and here. Too cold to plant. Ooh, we are in trouble. Alright. I wasn't anticipating winter, guys. So this is gonna that, but that seasons thing, you should be able to. Maybe it takes a little while to kick in, or I got to restart or something. So at least pick it up. I don't want her to eat the potato. All right, eat the potato. Get you some food. All right, so we have $189 to our name. doesn't look like there's much to forage out in this area. Let's see. You can dig up here. Tulips. I like this little area. I didn't even know this existed until I started this Let's Play. Started preparing for it. Just a little trail that comes up here to this bench. And you look off into the distance. I'll buy a comfortable cushion. I can't afford it. Come on, girl. Where you at? Stop exercising and get over here. Got these tulips. Wait, a rush. This boost of adrenaline is making Ima feel amazing. Should she firmly... Yeah, she likes. That up. Pick that up. Pick it up. Stop playing the guitar. See? Uh-oh, she's getting cold. Hang on. What weather is she in? I think she's wearing her everyday outfit. Let's see. Change outfit. She is wearing her cold weather. Ooh, it's really cold out here, huh? All right, girl. Well, it doesn't say you're freezing, does it? Pleasant chill. From ice-proof trait. Oh, she has an ice-proof trait? Ah, okay. Let's see if there's anything else to forage out here. Oh, see, that'll take her off a lot. She can't go there. She can go down here. Oh, there's a kitty kitty. Taco? What, Stacy? Taco. Oh, just right. All right, let's see. Ooh, we got food. Can she get to it before it turns? I suppose. Oh, it doesn't matter. Eat it. She's a freaking. All right. Get over here, girl. She's not. You ate. Your tummy's full. So let's see. Do, 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 do. they got here. Birds. Don't mess with the birds. Let them be. Let's get you some money. So we have a little more than what we had in the bank. Or in her piggy bank. And like I said, she got to go to the shop and drop to do that. She got to go to the shop and drop to sell these items that she gets. Come on. And they're scattered about, so she's got to travel to them. So it's going to cost her 5 simoleons to do it. She can't fish yet. She can have 150 simoleons to buy a fishing pole. Yes, I know you don't need to buy a fishing pole, but my sim does. We'll deduct 150 simoleons from them so they can fish. Until then, they cannot fish. No, no, no. All right, let's see. It's over here. Is that a pea bush? It's frozen. Dig. Dig, dig. All right. So come on over here. Oh, she's stinky. You're going to be stinky for a while, girl. Because we do not have the money to get you a shower yet. So let's come up here. Let's see what's up here. I haven't really traveled around here much. Can't travel to that house, but we can go here and dig. All right. How'd she get a minnow? Went fishing. Whatever. She can't get to that lot. All right. Looks like she's cleared this area. Get you home. What's this? Oh, frog. Get you a frog. Alright. You got the frog. Can you walk over there? Oh, you can. What's over there? Nothing. Alright. Let's get this. I know gameplay's a little slow. We're figuring this out. There's a couple of hiccups that we got, guys. We will get it, though. How'd you get over there? I guess you can go across the water. All right. Now she needs to go home. Where's her home? Home, where are you? There it is. Gosh, get lost in all this. All right. Let's get her here. You know what? She does have stuff, right? She can sell. Let's save one tulip. Let's open these. Let's see what we get. Extract fossil. Extract fossil. Extract fossil. Alright, we got 2 broken ones and 1 good one. We got a tree frog and a minnow. Common upgrade parts. And 6 tulips. Alright, guys. So, she is going to have to travel, and there's a travel point in that dock area where we were just at. Yeah, I know, not too convenient. Not like a bus comes around here to pick you up, but there's the only place that would fit. Ooh, and there's something over here. Madnet. Harvest the madnet. Alright, now let's take this bus. Oh, you can't afford it. That's right. We gotta get your money out of your piggy jar. Oh, man. Where is your lot? Oh, my God. Stones. Not a good time. Okay. So follow this just go to your piggy bank and take out some money. Take money. Let's take out. In case she wants to buy something while she's there. Let's do 50 simoleons. Alright. So now you gotta run all the way back, girl. You gotta pee or anything? Might as well do it while you're here. No, everything else looks good. Alright. Guess what? You gotta run all the way back. Sorry. Wherever it is. God, this is terrible. Oh, here we go. The snow. All right, go here. Get her running over here. All right. Get you to a warmer place. Place where you can collect some stuff, too. All right. I think we will go to Oasis Springs. I know it's probably snowing there. Does it snow in Oasis Springs? I don't remember. Alright, we're going to go to the Desert Park. Or Desert Bloom Park. Oh, yeah. A TARDIS restaurant. Download this from the internet. Or from the gallery. I was watching Dr. Gluon, one of Dr. Gluon's Let's Plays, 100 Baby Challenge. And he downloaded that. A friend of his made it for him. And it's a restaurant. It's a lot bigger than it looks. Yes, no snow. All right. Peace and quiet. All right, I did a little renovation to this, too. Not too much, but made it a little more Rags-Riches-friendly. I put this out here, the easel. Plopped in this shop and drop and put a basketball court out here and something to exercise, and put the two vending machines here, a chip vending machine and a soda vending machine. And in here, I took out that ragged speaker, that dreaded speaker that during my other Let's Plays, every time I tried to sleep, people would come in and turn the radio on and I couldn't sleep. So, but hey, this is a park, this is an allowed area in the game for my Rags to Riches, and I will be coming here to sleep once in a while. Cannot live here. So it means I cannot stay here. Probably I would set more than one day. I could stay the night here, but I can't stay two multiple nights. So, oh, she's very angry. What's she angry at? Oh, I cheated to get that movie. That's right. That's so I can set the Let's Play. Here, let's get her rid of that. Sorry, guys. Yeah, I cheated that one so I can get the beginning of that Let's Play set up. So, we are here. Oh, and she wants to sell stuff, but there's stuff here to collect, I believe. I think you have to be here for a certain amount of time before the stuff starts showing up, right? But there are things like dig. Things I can dig up. And I think it starts over. Other things to dig up. I guess they don't show up right away. And where are all the plants and everything? Huh, that's odd. There should be a tree here that you can harvest. Frog here, yeah. Huh. Yeah, there's a dig set. What's going on? That is strange. Maybe I All right. So, let's get back to her. And so what we have, sell. All right, let's get her over here. All right, sell all these. Let's sell six of these. 45 for this. 50 for that. Madnip. Yeah, I'm not gonna be using catnip. Medicine. I gotta keep my medicine. I can't sell it anyways. I'm selling this minnow. I don't know how I got it. I'm gonna sell that. I'm gonna sell all but one of these tulips because I will plant one. All right. So I have things in my inventory, don't I? That I. No. All right. So apparently everything in my inventory I can sell. Ooh, $315. All right. Good start, good start. So let's get you some snacks. Come over to the vending machine. Oh, you can upgrade it. Where does it make it? That's down on the quality upgrade. Never knew that. Never stuck. Oh, cool. Make unbreakable. Oh, that's cool. Maybe I'll come out here and fix some of these when I get a chance to. So let's buy some snacks. Something that she has. Since I hadn't prepared for the winter. Croissant. Great. Oh, look, you get grape, carrot, apple. Bolt energy bar. Protein bar. Peanut butter and jelly sandwich. Chips. Macaroni and cheese. Oh, wow. Just normal cooking items and some of the stuff that comes out of the ice cooler. That's cool. And a little extra edamame cake. Yeah. But you have to buy this stuff. So, let's see. Or is this stuff I can afford at this price? I don't know. So let's do peanut butter and jelly sandwich. Yeah. Cost me 5 simoleons. Ooh. Buy a drink. Oh, and if she drinks, she can drink water from public places, but like if she goes to, well, any other place, she would be charged that she can get into, like a cafe. She can get free water from the, so she can get into cafes for free. Energizing seltzer. She can get, she can go to cafes, parks, gyms, and spas. But if she goes to, like I said earlier, if she goes to a spa or gym, she's going to get charged 15 simoleons. So, better hope that when I load into a lot that she doesn't automatically run in it, or she can get tagged. Fizzy honey, melon soda. Let's get her melon soda. She doesn't have to eat it right now. I think after 2 hours, things start popping up when you're here. So let's get her in here and let's clean her up a little bit. Let's wash her hands a couple of times. Clog drain. Maybe I'll clog them when I leave. Wash hands. Wash hands. Brush teeth. And wash hands. So let's get her looking a little better. Who are you? What? Woman? Can't you see I'm trying to clean? Oh, you're a teen, huh? Do you want to be my friend? Here, beg for money. What's she doing? Oh, she's talking in the mirror. She didn't even see me here. She was like talking over my shoulder. Isn't that rude? Come on, take the money. Oh, she got 6 simoleons. And I think there's a function where she can stand here. Are there people here? go here. And I think if I click on her, yeah, I beg for money. Interaction that lasts a while. So she sits there and she just begs for money. So let's see. Either scare people off or don't. Oh, look. She yelled at me. I just gave you money. Oh, look, got money. Oh, 15, 15. Oh, look at this. Oh, this is so sweet. I guess this is the tuning from, like, playing the guitar or something in that on that thing you get on the street. You put on the street. Oh, look, another five. Oh, yeah. Wow. That is so cool. All right. I don't want to sit here and do this all night. I got stuff to do. She's tired. So she's going to get, oh, and this thing you can also use the bathroom and travel, but it costs a little more to travel from here. I guess that's like the taxi service or something. So let's see if this works. I mean, she's going to take a nap out here. Does anyone leave food? No. All right. So she's going to take a nap. Without the music here, she should be able to sleep pretty good. Right? It looks like it. No. Oh, naps are only for so long, like 15 or let's see. How's she look? Nap. She's hungry. She's got to go pee. Let's take another nap. One more nap. All right. All right. So her hygiene is back down. She's got to eat. You got something in your pocket, don't you? Peanut butter and jelly sandwich. I guess they don't spoil. I mean, at least not in from the machine. All right. So I can't sleep here the next night. So Thursday, or tonight, Wednesday night, I can't sleep here. Thursday, I can come. Oh, no. I slept here through Wednesday, so Thursday. So Friday, like, let's say every 2 days. She's, look at, pulls the drink out. She's drinking her stuff. Getting her energy up. Let's see what her energy looks like. Okay. Filling her up, too. I like that. Yeah, that vending machine is a good idea. I know it comes from Snowy Escape, the original concept of it. But the way she, Ravishing has made these, it's a little more accessible to common items. I think a little cheaper, too. I know you got to go to the bathroom. Just finish your drink first. Grab your drink. Oh, throw it away. Leave it there. All right. Oh, she's going to use this bathroom. Oh, let's let her use it so you can see what the how it works. For those of you that haven't used this. So she comes to the back. She got a rabbit hole. It's a rabbit hole function where she just disappears. Does she not? Oh, it closed. It closed before she got there. Oh, poor girl. Oh, 3 a.m. it closes. Yeah, see, that's what I like about that thing. So she missed out. She could have peed there, but she was doing that waddle walk and missed out. All right, so that's cool. Before she heads back, she's going to grab a couple of snacks. Did she pee? Be like a champ. Come on, let's finish this. Okay. What are you waving? You can't do. What can't you do? Can you walk over here? Alright. So let's buy some stuff. The peanut butter and jelly sandwich seem to fill you up, huh? Where's the ham and cheese? You like peanut butter. Reminds you of being a child. Get you a couple of those. Get you another one. And let's buy you a drink. Chilled sage green tea. Wish they had like a description on what they like, if they give you anything. Uh oh. Did she get it? The items she purchased can be found in her inventory. Let's see. Yep, it's there. Yep. Oh, let's save. That's all we need, huh? Something happened. We didn't save. Oh, yeah. I didn't get rid of the, sorry, guys. I didn't get rid of the speaker. I just moved it out here. That way she could sleep if she needed to. So. All right. Now that we're here, we did our stuff. Oh, let's see if things started growing, popping up. Oh, yeah. See, they weren't here earlier. That's weird. All right. Let's run around and dig this stuff up. She's going to be too uncomfortable to finish some of these. Let's get her to wash her hands a few times. Wash your hands. Wash your hands. Wash your hands. Brush your teeth. Come on. Was she? Oh, she was drinking her soda. She was thirsty. Well, I guess. Drink your soda. Alright. So let's finish our rounds. I like going to this place. It's got a lot of stuff. A lot of collectibles. Alright. So. Well, lady, sorry to tell you, but you ain't getting no social. Dig. Oh, I guess I could have digged for treasure. I guess I got a treasure map. Let's see, do I have a treasure map? Oh, I do. All right, let's dig for a treasure on the next one. Go here. Let's get you some money. I know you're getting tired. Alright. You got some spleen in you. You got some stuff to collect. What's here? Blackbird. We gotta come back and get blackbirds. You can make some good money from those. Alright, let's dig for treasure. Come on up here. You tinky again, huh? Well, it's raining, right? Well, let's utilize the rain. No. Playing rain. Can't you, like, shower in the rain? Playing in the rain. Huh. I guess you have to be an adult. Oh, well. All right. Well, that would make sense. Get rid of the umbrella, lady. I'll take your umbrella away. All right. You're almost done. Let's come back down here. I'm gonna not return to act a lot. I'm not allowed to. Are you like hiding from the rain or passing out? I want you to pass out. Cannot return home. I will not. Oh, here, take a nap. All right. She's gonna get in a few winks here. No. Take another nap. Come on. Let's get you sleeping. Let's get your energy up a little bit. Oh, and it's raining. Oh, man. Sleep through the rain. Sleep through the rain. Get that energy up enough so where you can do something. Man, she's just like having a rough go of this. Should have stayed at home, girl. Should have stayed at home. All right. So, enough to get some of this stuff here. And then we'll take the bus over Lemetry. Ooh, yeah, she can get a lemon. Let's get this. She's too uncomfortable. Ah! All right. I want to come back and get that lemon. So let's bring her over here. Get her to sit down. All right. Get her out of the rain for a bit. Oh, she can't sleep here. All right. Then let's get you home. Take the bus. I know you guys are all screaming, oh, you said you can't sleep here 2 nights in a row. Well, you're right. I can't. But let's get you off the chair. Where you at? Where you at? Where are you at? Oh, there you are. Oh, God, she's just miserable. All right, let's get you home. Let's get you home. Reynolds Bay. Your home lot. Man. She picked the wrong time to run away. I wasn't planning on that to happen. I figured she'd have a season or two. Oh, man. It was going to be a little rougher than I thought. All right, so here we are. At least enough. Blizzard right now. Gosh. All right, so she has some money. Let's see. She needs to be able to cook. So there is... How many stuff here? There's only one rose. Here. All right, what was my thing? I said shrub removal is 50 simoleons. All right, so she has 313 now. Let me sell this. So I gotta take away. +75. God, my math sucks, guys. That's early. 16 plus 75. Quit yelling at me, guys. I know. 91. I gotta take $91 away from her. So, oh, I think I saw a cheat with Dr. Glue on. Negative 91, is that it? Oh no, 347, what? $347, that's what she had. Oh no, you add it. Negative 91, add it? Yes, all right. Cool, good. All All right, so now she can cook. Are we still off the grid? Let me make sure. Like I said, I've got them that challenge that rotates. See, she's back on the grid. Simple living. Off the grid. Got to make sure they're on. Every time I do something, that has to do with that. All right. Since I'm here, is there anything else that she needs to get closer to? Maybe let's get this out of here. Right. Yeah, let's delete that. So, simoleons negative 91. That's what we figured it is. Cause it was the same thing. Rosebush added. All right, she's back down to 181 plus what's in her little kitty jar. All right, guys. So, let's. Get out of build mode. Let's get her over here. Let's see what she can do here. Gather snow. Oh, yeah. She can gather snow for what? Well, I know it's to... Oh, for the ice chest. Aha. Yeah, she can't get to it yet. Let's go here. I got a question. If you build a snowman, can you talk to it? Let's do that. Build a snowman. Maybe she can get her phone up. No, she's getting her phone up. Can't she get her soap up that way too? Can't she talk to it? Come on. Build it. Build it. Come on. I know you're going to pass out before that happens. Nope. Can't sleep in the bush. Get out of the bush. If you're going to sleep, you got to sleep here. Alright. Let's get some of your needs up a little bit. Let's get... yeah, that's long enough. Continue a bit on the snow pad. Alright, come on, girl. Get up. Finish that. I know, I know. I know you're hungry. What the heck is that? That's a snow pad. Can you talk to it? Let's name him Fred. I wish you could build it and talk to it. Oh, yeah. Also, there's supposed to be dogs showing up on this live. It's dog friendly, right? Here, sorry about that, guys. Let me go back here. Make sure I have dog friendly set up. I did this to help with her talking, getting her social back up. Yeah, it's dog friendly. Dog hangout. Let me add shift click Nisa's light. Add lot trait. Next. Next. See, this is all the stuff I said that you can add to the lot and make it. Landfill as well. Next. I guess I already have the dog traits. Next. I like this one. No special walk style on that. The fame walk style. Slow walk style. Yeah. Got rid of that. Well, I'd like to get rid of that. Okay. Dog friendly. Yes. Alright. Let's get out of here. That should bring the doggies around. Dog should be showing up soon. So you got some food in your inventory, right? A couple of PBJs. Yep. Why don't you eat one? Is it spoiled? does it. Or is she stinky? Might be her. No, it looks like it's coming from that too. I know she's stinky. She's stinky. Oh, get out. No, it's not on. All right. Oh, yeah. We're going to have problems with trash if I can't get over to that. All right. Hygiene, have no way to get that up right now. Let's have her sleep. Oh, let's make some snow angels. Get your fun up. Yeah? I did a little bit. You're going to bed, huh? And you're out. That's so cool. Yeah, what is that? That dance mat that you get from reaching like level 3 or something of the dance skill. She took that dance mat and turned it into a sleeping mat. It's kind of cool. Oh, hey, look, old Saint Nick. Hey, he showed up. Oh, it's winter. Oh my gosh, I didn't even know it. I wasn't even paying attention. Fight with Father Winter for presents. No, I want to get something. Hope it'll be something good. Let's just do a friendly introduction. Maybe I'll be able to get that function after I get a present. All right, ask for present. What I get? There was literally, you know what? I should have fought you for a present. I'm going to pickpocket you. There was literally nothing in there other than sadness and lies. What you get? She got something. I'm ahead of learn to pick the pocket of unassuming Sims. Did she get anything? Small Sims can pick. But beware. Low chances are. Okay, but did she get something? Guess not. Just a satisfaction of pickpocketing. Come on, Santa, please. Please, Santa. Money, give me some money. I am just a poor, young, lonely teen. Can I have some money, please, Santa? Please. Aw, give me 5 smokes. Aw, thank you. Now, can you leave? Let's see. I don't want to make friends with Santa. Gotta get this up. Things about the steel. Really the steel. I know they're just repetitive. There we go. Fight for Father Winter. Yes. Come on. Come on. Let's fight Father Winter. Yeah. Give me my dang present. Ooh, what was that box that went flying? look, presents. Father Winter, I'm out here in the cold, and you get me nothing? Well, take this. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, she's mad. Look at her. She's just tearing him up. He's like, oh, no, I gotta go. Dang, she's just giving it to him. You give me an empty box for Christmas? You're supposed to be nice. They're fighting a long time. He got presents. Sims around the world are losing presents. Oh, she didn't win. Oh, man. I am fighting you again. You've got to win. You've got to get your present. Come on. Come on, you gotta win. She has no athletic skill. Did she? Oh, man. All right. Santa, you're going to be my sworn enemy. Declare enemy. Bite you one more time. Sorry, guys. This is kind of funny. Run for shelter. Come on, mean. Fight for the winner. Give me my present. You ain't gonna win, girl. You gotta get up your skills. Maybe next year. Yeah. Get out of here. Tell him to leave. Let's see. Beg for money? He's not gonna give me money. Oh, never mind. He's just going to sleep right here. Face full of snow. She's out. All right, guys. First Let's Play. Our first episode of the Generations Rag to Riches Let's Play Legacy. I will be recording another video right after this because I want to keep playing. So, but I figured this would be long enough. I have no idea how long it is. 2 hours and 24 minutes. Woo! I'm going to probably have to cut that down. Maybe break that up into a couple episodes. So, yeah. Thank you for sticking around. I hope you stuck around. Give a like, share, and subscribe. I will try to pump these out as quick as I can. Until next time. So.